Close the door, put your hands on the wheel, and get us out of here, fast.
Who is it?
It's another agent.
Answer.
Hello? I don't know, I'm kind of busy. He wants us to come pick him up.
We have to. Pick him up.
Yeah, I'll be there in a minute. Hey, just get in the back.
Give me the keys. Get out.
Guns to the back now. You're still the same, Roland. You've passed the test.
What's going on, Virgo?
I've got some things I need taken care of.
Look, I'm not playing your games no more. I quit your business a long time ago, and I quit for good.
Well, you can think about it. I'll leave you alone. Oh, and by the way, a few of your friends are missing. But don't worry, they're here safe and sound with me.
Okay, I'm listening.
Well, here's the deal. Tomorrow, Adam Bennington has a private business meeting all the way in Houston. I have an inside man, so I know his exact route and some details. I need you to intercept him and bring him back to me. It's that simple.
Who is Adam Bennington, and why do you want him?
Don't you watch the news, Roland? He's the founder and CEO of Bencorp. He's worth about $1.3 billion, and you know I'm always in it for the money.
Make or take.
What happened to you, Roland? We used to have the biggest crime organization in Brazil, man. I know you didn't leave for the poor pay because you're getting almost as much as me.
Everyone has a conscience, and mine caught up with me. I couldn't take any longer, not knowing if I was going to live to see the next day. I needed something different.
Thank God I don't have a conscience, or I would be dead. Look, man, just do this one thing for me, and I'll split the earnings with you 50-50. I know you're ready to come back. You're an undercover cop. There's unlimited possibilities. We could get away with anything.
I don't know. I don't know. This is big.
Here's the deal. Come to my house tomorrow. We can talk about it face to face, okay? Personal. No one else will be there. That sounds good? Cool. Okay, and by the way, your friends aren't missing anymore. I let them go. I'll see you later.
What's the game plan?
Well, there's been a small change. I found a bigger job, but I think I'll still use your help.
How much bigger?
It's called gun running. Be back in the 80s. I think it's hitting again.
Sounds easy enough. When do we start?
Itching to get back to work? I like that. Tomorrow we'll leave at 6 and go to this warehouse outside town. There's a big supply of weapons there.
Who's the seller?
He calls himself Max. That's all I know. But to set things straight, we're not buying. We're taking.
That's kind of dangerous, don't you think? Stealing from a man who sells guns?
Yeah, it is, I guess, but if it wasn't, wouldn't be any fun, would it?
So what are we going to do? Walk in, take everything, and leave?
Sounds like a plan to me. Come on, I'll introduce you to the rest of the team. Alright, guys. This is Roland. He'll be leading you on the operation. Okay, Roland. This is Matt Sloan. He served in the Marines for 8 years, and he's top of his class for 3. He's a third-degree black belt karate. This is Chris. He's been 10 years in the Secret Service and was top of his class in marksmanship. I think I had a little run-in yesterday. Max's warehouse is out of town, so it's going to be kind of rough, but I got a meeting in about half an hour, so you get your game plan together and I'll meet you here at 8 a.m. in the morning.
Can do it without him?
Let's do it while Max is in here.
It's clear.
I think I heard something. Here.
Oh.
crates are in here.
Is this it?
Yeah.
This is where it ends. Chris, please take care of him. Thanks for a well-executed game plan. Sorry it had to end this way, but you're caught, man. It's just too weird.
So why is Virgo doing all this? You're gonna kill me, might as well just tell me.
Hello.
Ned, you know who this is?
Roland, I thought Virgo had you killed.
Are you still working for him? I haven't seen you.
No, I'm on my own, but I know everything that's going on with him. I have a mole in his henchman.
God, it must be bad when the crime organization's putting moles in others.
What happened with you? Last I heard, you and Berger were gun running together. Then I heard you were going to be killed after the mission. How did you get out of that?
His guard had to catch another ride. Look, I need your help. Berger just stole 2 crates loaded with guns.
I know. He's planning on taking over every small crime organization, gang, anybody who's ever killed somebody or stolen something. He wants them.
But why? That would make it a lot easier for the authorities to find him and shut him down. What does he think he is, the Godfather?
I don't know, man. He left me a message. You won't believe this.
What?
He wants all of New York. He wants to be the Don.
This isn't the 1950s. This is 2006.
Well, as of right now, he has the weapons and almost all the men he needs to take over the city. It's getting out of hand, and we can't actually go to the police.
But if he's dead, then no one else would go through with this crazy idea.
Possibly. What are you getting at?
What are you doing tonight?
Look, I told you everything I know. I can't help you anymore.
Fine, I'll do it myself.
You know me, I used to get caught up in everyday life, trying to make it through my day so I could sleep at night, trying to figure out my way through the maze of rights and wrongs, but like you used to say, nothing feels like it's really worth it. Forget perfect, I'm trying not to be worthless. Since I last saw you, I've been looking for a purpose. Well, I met this kid who thought like I did. He had a weird way of looking at it. This is what he said. Slip out the back before they know you were there, and at the worst, you'll see nobody cares. Cause you don't wanna be around when it all goes down. Even heroes know when to be scared. Slip out the back before they know you were there, and at the worst, you'll see nobody cares. Cause you don't wanna be around when it all goes down. Even heroes know when to be scared.
Now, I don't remember where I met him or remember his name, but he walked funny like he was just too big for his frame. Just over 5 foot, but he weighed 150. And what he said seemed so right, it stuck with me. Listen, it's like poker, you can play your best, but you gotta know when to fold your cards and take a rest. And know when to hold your cards, hold your breath, and hope that nobody else is stacking the deck.
Slip out the back before they know you were there, and at the worst you'll see.
This is where it ends, Virgo. Last scene of Faceless, the last making.
The last scene right here.
I died like 5 times.
He asked Ned for help, but Ned said no. Had to do it myself, so off we go. Crazy man wants guns, wants the town. Well, thanks to himself.
Yo, this man's a clown.
Threatens my family, so no, I guess I'm in. Hop in my car, 20 grams up to spin. I'm off to meet Virgo, I wish this would end. The end is so near, the smell of fear is gone. At first the game's over, but now it's back on. Off the truck, there was just my pump. Think about my life, how it's gonna be without Virgo or his military.
Oh, it's Patrick O'Hoolahan.
Oh, what holes?
Don't talk, Andrew. He's gonna say it, okay? You just wait. Sorry.
Okay.
Hello, I got.
Alright. Hello?
Andrew, shut up. I'll say it when I'm ready, okay? Hello? He can't do that. He can't be talking. He's making me
put it on speakerphone, dude, so we can... Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh,
did you hear my shoulder? Oh, my God. I popped my shoulder out of place. What? Hello? Hello?
no, I'm not naked.
Hello?
Hello, Detective Rowling.
Who is this?
Your name right now. If you want to know more, just meet me at 101.
Huh? 104 Mill Street. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Detective Rowling.
Who is this?
Room number one, no names. But if you want to know more, meet me at 104 Cauldron Street.
Was that bad?
I could not remember. I was like,
104. Cauldron Street.
Mom, anyway.
Are we dying here? We have enough film.
No, we have like 15 minutes here.
The bank. Bank.
So I'm gonna shoot you in the kidney with a BB gun.
He took all the money out of the bank. He has the key to the bakery.
Gun running is a big thing back in the 80s.
The camera's on you, Andrew. Oh.
Gun running was a big thing back. Oh my goodness!
The phone. Shut it up.
Hello?
No, I'm not answering it.
Hello?
I'm not talking.
What is that?
It's a prank call. Come on. It's probably Gina Snitch.
Hello? Sound like Morse code or something. Is that y'all doing that to me?
No. Oh my god! Why would you leave? Why would we do that to you? Alright, Mom, come on.
Unknown caller.
Go!
You know me? I'm gonna find an unknown.
Please, Mom.
Gun running. Big thing back in the 80s, I think it's hitting again.
What's so funny about
that? Page. You had the back page.
Oh.
Gun running. It was big back in the 80s, and I think it's hitting again.
Sounds easy enough. Who's the seller?
Itching to get back to work? Why'd you say both of us together? That said that's the only two parts you say. Probably said who's the seller. What is that?
Andrew, look over the paper.
3, 2,
action!
It's called gun running. Supposedly big back in the 80s. I think it's hitting again.
Sounds easy enough. When can we start it?
When can we get started? I'm just going to start it.
3, 2, action.
Say it's called gun running. Big whoa! Oh, oh.
I can't look at you.
Can't look away. Don't laugh either.
Alright, whenever y'all are ready,
this
rolling.
This is serious. This rolling. Is serious.
Rolling, do it.
Hold on.
Batman is dying. Batman is about to die.
Okay. It's called gun running. Big back in the 80s. I think it's hitting again.
Ah.
Yes.
Can we just start it with
I said going? It so serious there.
Into action.
It's called gun running. Big in the 80s.
It's hitting again.
It's hitting again.
It's hitting again. Crash is
gun running.
We got hurt, guys.
Back in the 80s.
Okay.
It's hitting again.
Let's get ready.
Action.
Serious.
He calls himself Max. That's all I know. To set things straight, we're bot or not.
Fine, we're taking.
How's he, man?
He calls himself Max, that's all I know. To set things straight, we're not buying, we're taking.
That's kind of dangerous, don't you think? Stealing from a man?
That's horrible. That's the only reason it does.
Alright.
Okay, we're taking.
That's kind of dangerous, don't you think? Stealing from a man who sells guns?
Yeah, it is, I guess. But then if it wasn't, I guess it wouldn't be any fun. Yeah, it is, I guess, but if it wasn't, wouldn't be any fun, would it?
So what are we going to do? Just walk in there and leave with everything?
Remember me?
And like Amber, and I keep saying names. It's like,
no, it's Stacy.
And then she's just physical. And then it's like Bacardi and Diet.
Are you seeing our faces on this one?
Yeah.
Alright. Feel sweaty.
Bacardi. Cola.
We can get the job done.
Da 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 da
get behind me?
Three.
Two. Action.
Where's Virgo and Chris?
They're still talking.
So we're gonna do it without them?
Yeah.
Action.
Where's Chris and Virgo?
They're still talking.
We're just gonna do it without them?
Max is here. Yeah, boy. Action.
Keep on going.
Where's Chris?
Okay, y'all. That was good. What was that? We like.
Where's Chris and Virgo?
They're still talking.
We gonna wait for him?
No, Max is in here. Let's do it without him.
That sucks.
Go.
Where's Chris and Virgo?
They're still talking.
We just gonna do it without him?
Max is in here. So let's get this party started. Oh, what was that? I was already going.
Where's Chris and Bert? God. I can't do that. Okay, it works on like doing that.
Yeah.
And then. So, Mr. Crawford.
Yes, sir.
What is your part in this movie?
I play some voices. Because I really extend my voice vocal cords. Would you like to hear some?
That won't be necessary.
Okay, that sucks, because that's all I'm good at. I'm also the villain.
There's a big part in the movie when you're not in it. And, what are you doing from that time?
Off-screen relationships, mostly with the characters. I mean,
would nice these guys. Be male characters, I'm guessing?
Some of them.
Okay.
I'd really not like not to discuss this. It's really awkward for me.
So are these male off-screen relationships? Or?
Yes, they are.
Okay.
Please stop talking about it. I'm starting to breathe pretty hard.
So these are males, right?
There's some females.
No. Yeah, females without the fee. I mean, obviously you're...
Do you like females? Do you like males? What do you like? You want to do a little reverse? Do you want to turn around?
This is your interview.
No, I think
anyway, off the subject, you're gay, okay? That's okay.
Just because your people know you're naked.
What's your favorite scene in the movie?
My makeout scene, definitely.
Sir, you don't have one of those.
Oh, it'll come. I know it'll come.
Yeah.
And I am having an off-screen relationship.
With the mill?
Blake Hodges, specifically. I took him from you. I'm sorry.
Blake's been around with a lot of people.
They say I'm irresistible. Can I please do my voice?
You ask for a time? 30 seconds? Okay, you got 30 seconds.
Hello, Detective Roland. That'll be it. Thank you.
So, Mr. Boyce, have you had a good time making this movie? Besides, I work with amateurs?
Yeah, I've had pretty fun.
Who specifically are these amateurs?
Well, Blake Hodges is a complete amateur.
Did you have an off-screen relationship with him?
That question is not even accurate.
Okay, we'll go to that later. Anyways, what's your favorite scene so far?
When I killed Blake Hodges.
Did you have an off-screen relationship with him?
I really don't think that's adequate.
Oh, I thought you already asked that. What, my fault. Okay. Do you like driving the nice cars in the film?
You think they're nice if they had an engine in them.
Oh, that would suck. I'd kill myself.
They're pretty cheap.
So what about that producer, Derek? Is he cool or is he a douche?
He's another amateur. He's pretty hard to get along with.
I've never even seen his name in the movie. You know, business.
Well, when you just throw hot coffee in someone's face, it's not a nice gesture.
Do you have an off-screen relationship with him?
Like, sir, that question is not even adequate.
Totally different person. Just trying. Hey, I'm just trying.
No, I did not.
Okay.
I did not have sex with anyone.
You like guys?
Any males.
Do you like males at all?
Sir, that question is not.
It's a rumor I've heard. You can get angry. I'm going to ask.
Who said that?
I can't tell you. You'll kill him.
Did Blake say that?
No, Blake Hodges is dead.
Sure, I killed him.
He's a low-cut actor. He's an amateur. Mm-hmm. That's your word. I'm not saying this. This is your word. He deserves
amateur.
To die.
Amateur.
Okay. So last question. Will you remain in the off-screen relationship with Derek and Blake?
Is this a joke? Is this for real?
I'm serious.
I'm out of here.
Please, sir. I really need this. I'm going to lose my job.
I need some coffee.
Yeah.